Anniversaries are funny things. Whether it's your wedding anniversary, the anniversary of starting a new professional position, or even a birthday. Anniversaries bring out this human tendency we have that's almost unavoidable. When celebrating an anniversary, we most always look backwards. If it's your wedding anniversary, you think about that particular day. You think about the service. Maybe you go through the photographs. My wife has us go through the photographs every anniversary. And I look great. So does she. But you have that tendency to look back at the event and to think about everything that's transpired in your life together up to the present moment. And rarely do you think about what's ahead. The same with work. We mark our tenure. We list in our heads all the accomplishments. Some good, some not great, that have happened throughout our professional time. But rarely do we think about what's before us. Even with our birthdays, we think about the length of our days and what's happened in the past. And rarely think about what we'll do in the future. My mother loves to look back at my birth. She loves to talk about the pain that she experienced in childbirth. And I oftentimes remind her that I was minding my own business in the primordial muck until she and my father decided to yank me into this world. And we all know that looking at the past is important. Because knowing where we've been helps us understand where we are. And it can help us understand where we're going. Sometimes we talk about Pentecost, this great feast of the church year, the arrival of the Holy Spirit. John full of the Spirit right here. And we talk about it being the church's birthday. And I know what that means. I know what we're trying to say, that something significant happened on this day. And we received that culminating experience of God's presence in the form of the Spirit. But we don't celebrate this great feast of the church year to dwell on that day. We don't celebrate this feast of the church year to look backwards towards it. We celebrate this feast to recognize that the Spirit is present among us now. And that the Spirit desires to take us someplace. Not leave us, but just take us into God's future. Uniting us, supporting us, sustaining us, and walking with us into God's unfolding future. Think about the lessons that we've heard. Your sons and daughters shall prophesy. Young people shall see visions. Old people shall dream. Windows into heaven and earth will appear. Everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. That's what the witnesses of the first Pentecost thought was happening. They thought the process was beginning. And that through the Spirit's presence and the Spirit's arrival, They were walking with God in a new and different way, forward into the future. Now, as Jesus bestows the Spirit on the disciples, he does something very interesting. Now, the text is a little tricky here, so you're going to have to trust me. The text should read that Jesus breathed into his disciples, not on them. And these words are very important. Jesus breathing into them, because they're intended to call us back to the very creation of the world and the first human being, Adam. When God creates Adam out of the dust, when everything is complete except having life, God breathes life into him. And Adam is animated and brought to life. So when Jesus breathes into the disciples, he's transforming their lives forever. And he's giving them a new and changed life, grounded in right relationship with God, granted with using one's gifts in service of the gospel, to share that saving story, the story we inherit from the past, the story that we know now, and the story that the church is called to tell forever. That's why we baptize this day. It's not about a sweet moment where a lovely child dressed in white will have a moment in front of us all that we are to look back on and have one of those, gosh, anyone under 50 is not going to get this, to have one of those RCA dog moments. You remember the dog that turns his head? Oh, that's not what this is about. This is about the Spirit becoming present in the lives of these children, animating their lives and grafting them into the tree of Christ. Spirit lives now and forever and will be part of the lives of these children now and forever. I'm almost finished. You don't have to go. It's all good. It's all good. So for all of us, there's an alpha moment. The first letter of the Greek alphabet, the beginning. For these children, baptism is an alpha moment. But alpha is just one point. There's also omega, the final word, letter rather, of the Greek alphabet. Every alpha has an endpoint, a destination. Life is full of little alphas and little omegas. And the Spirit walks with us through them all. And the Spirit will walk through us with that eternal alpha and omega as well. From beginning to God's end.